Hello. So, I'm starting a little fun series where I play Rome 2 Total War, Total War Rome 2. I don't know how it goes. The quality is not good. The time I'm able to play slash record is when my kids are in bed, so this is essentially the level I have to talk at, so I don't wake any of them up. Also, my computer is okay. This is the webcam for it. Not the best quality. So yeah, the graphics and all that are not the best, but my computer actually runs it really well. All things considered, at least. So if you enjoy watching gameplay stuff, you should have fun with this. I mean, really, a lot of the comedy is just going to come in the fact that I'm usually playing this when I'm really tired, trying to be quiet, whatever other issues. This should be hopefully a fun series. I'm going to try to keep about an hour or so, if that's doable. Again, excuse the poor quality, but I hope it's a fun series for you guys. Welcome to Arto Plays. Okay. Well, this is the first time I'm trying this, so it's going to be a little awkward at first. I'm Artokatos, and I am playing Rome 2 Total War Emperor Edition. Grand Campaign, and I'm playing as the the Averni tribe.
Your old rivals, the Aedui, are forever seeking to thwart you. If they will not join your cause, then you must march unprotected and take it by storm. You may find support from your Pictinese allies, but remember that your enemies also have support. Seek the allegiance of our
I don't know
allied
if you
tribes
are hearing
and
the
crush
narration.
all who oppose you. Gaul must be unified. Trade with the Greeks of Massilia will bring you wine and wealth, but maintaining contact with Mediterranean farmmongers will inevitably lead to conflict. By Drutatis, they will feel the might of a united Gaul. So speak the Averni.
Right. So, this is probably one of my favorite games. I love the Total War franchise. And the fact that I can play as Gauls in this is just a dream come true. And this will be the first of a series of Total War gameplay. Eventually, I'll branch out into other games as well, but this was the first on my list because it is really get to play as Gaul, so why not? So, to kind of make this a little more challenging, I'm going to mainly focus on the objectives, which is establish trade relations with Massalia. Forge a defensive or military alliance with the Fallen Fifth with the Sequani. And capture the last remaining something. Anyway, pretty basic. And then the main one is to control two provinces either by direct ownership or through military alliances. So those are my goals that I'm going to try to excuse me, achieve. First things first, let's build some enclosed lands so we can get some food production. See what we have on the board here. We've got a spy. Let's get Lugios. Get him over to Bibract. Come on. Yeah, my computer's not the best for playing games, but this is, out of all the games I have on here, this one actually performs the best. So, definitely fortunate there. We're gonna do steal food. This will disrupt them, hopefully. Alright, we got two armies. First, let's those Celtic warriors. Let's do. They all unlock Celtic or spear warriors. So this one will probably be the best because of it. Also boosting the public order. Not enough to upgrade my farmstead gold mine, which is that's okay. Next thing, let's get some technology going. Definitely gonna be fighting the Aedui right from the get-go, so let's just get some supply foraging going. What do we got here? We got General Iliatos. Some levy freemen. Celtic youth and then slingers. What we have in the headhunter army, just a couple of freemen plus the king. Alright, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna put my king over here, kind of cut the distance of him having to walk. We are going to have this general, just the sons of Brennus. He can keep slingers. Fuck slingers. Drop all that. Have him go back to the capital and set there as defense. And, let's add a slinger and some levy freemen. Actually, you know what? I will do that, but just let's get the king's army, the headhunters. Okay. Let's. Get some Celtic warriors in there and do a couple more youths. I suck at words. Okay, now we'll do the. Okay, out of money. Alright, that's fine. That'll be okay. Don't expect anyone to be really attacking me just yet, so. Let's check in on the politics. Alright. So we have Seahorse Clan. Our general, let's give him a promotion. He's no good stuff. Seahorse Clan, let's give all these guys just a freebie promotion. That will affect the tax rate and other things. Okay, next. Not really much else I can do there. Okay. Do a trade agreement. Boom. Although my honor cries out against it. Oh, shut up. Have much truth in them. Also do non-aggression pact. I really don't feel like fighting them this early. Your words bring satisfaction to the gods and to my people. Okay, let's see if we can partner up the Vivisky. It's gonna be too low. I don't know if pressure packs will go. Alright, fuck you guys then. That is about everything we can do for now. And turn.
are not too talkative. It is pretty late at night, and this is kind of like my relaxed time. I guess the real bummer, if I, because I need it, I need to get this off my chest. But the real bummer is that you cannot play without mods. You can't play as the Helvetii, and that really bothers me. And not only that, but their color scheme and their logo is fucking ugly. I mean, I guess, you know, gray and yellow works alright, but it's such an ugly faction color, because all the units are gray, because I've played with the mods before, and they are fun to play as, but I don't know, I'm always paranoid that mods are going to fuck up my computer. Oh, excuse me, I had some homemade burgers. Okay, so we got, that'll be next turn, that'll be the next turn. One more turn for that, that should be a good size army, and then, thanks to my thief, they are taking down, these guys, and of course they're actively recruiting, so they're just, not really going to be able to do much, because their numbers are going to start to, attrition's going to hit them, and, because they're low on food, thanks to me. Okay, let's get back into the politics. See what all we can do. Let's get him a wife. Promote her. Actually, you know what? Let's see if we can get one of these guys to look at their stats. Let's do this. Send him to the Visky. See if he can do some diplomacy and get them to like me better. Yeah, I can't really do much else. I got the Pictones, our defensive ally. Can't establish trade with Namnentes. I can't say that. Carnutes are out of the way still. So, I'm trying to play this a little realistically, so I don't want to completely destroy the Aedui. I'm just going to kind of beat them down and see if I can force them into a confederation. Rather than just trying to decimate them all. But I'm not seeing any other moves I can do for now, so let's go ahead and turn. I don't think I have the music playing. I think that's why it's so quiet. Just a little bit. Same game. Yeah, that should be better. I really love how they have the little effects of showing the construction equipment and things like that. There's little boar, little piggies out in the woods. Alright, what's the word? Look on the tree. Consequence, your judgment has been wounded. It had. Oh shit, that isn't good. Okay, I've got an increase in rank. Let's. I want you to keep messing them up, so we're gonna increase that skill, which will mean stealing more food. Don't quite have money to do that just yet. Honestly, I'm sure about the number of other returns. No, that's not good. That's not good, sir. Nope. Our recruitment's done for now. Okay, we now have the military tree unlocked. Just to make it even, we have 2 turns right there. Alright, yeah, that pissed these guys off, me trying to be friendly with them, so I'm gonna just slowly build up this army. Let's get some Tilted Warriors in there to kind of add some meat to the bone. Cavalry Freemen are great, they're cheap, but their morale is just awful. Like, it's just awful. Alright, so let's get him across the border and get him into a raiding stance. I'll bring in some extra money and I'll piss them off. Plus, I don't really want to full on attack a place and snow. It just seems like a very poor move to make. Let's see. Let's get our heir on the Oryx. On the Oryx? I just. Jesus Christ. Let's get him married. We need to keep the bloodline going. Alright. And that's basically all I can do for now. I don't plan on being on for too much longer. I definitely want to just try this out and test out how this is even going to work. I really have no idea what I am doing when it comes to technology, so this is this is new for me, learning experience, so it is, just like with the podcast, it'll all get better in time. Let's move you guys further up, still in that raiding stance. Yeah, that's gonna be rough when they decide to finally fight. Damn it. 2,000 gold, that's ridiculous. Can't do much there yet. Let's Oh, there we go. Spear warriors. Get some spear warriors in there. Yeah, you do that. With the vanilla game, you can play as. Actually, I think it's just the Averni. You have to get some of the DLC to unlock, like the Nervi and the Boi and the Galatians. That was a lot of fun because it's because it takes place in Anatolia, so you're fighting against a lot of nomadic and Greek and Arab.
As they all gather, wise men look for friends to sell to them. In you, I believe we have such friends.
But yeah, you're dealing with Arab factions and Greek factions. It makes it really unique. The thing about fighting against Greek factions is the fucking phalanx. I hate it. It's such a pain in the ass to deal with. Unless you can just strictly focus on combining your infantry and cavalry, which is easier, in certain situations easier said than done. Sometimes the computer kind of throws you for a loop, and they're actually pretty good at maneuvering those guys at the last second, which not fun. I mean, it's not boring. It's not always fun. Anyway, so the Nantes. Not crash, but that's fine. That's fine. I'm gonna try to ally with them later.
Here is your lust. Now come the ravens. Beat the gate for your guts. Look at all our soldiers.
Yep, I called that one. That was my own fault. Peace negotiators. Alright, let's get some advanced saddle going. Especially when we finally get. Stables. Okay, they're not sending anything over here just yet, so we're gonna mess with the politics or the diplomacy just because there's really nothing else I can do for the moment, so I'm just going to I always do sets of four when it comes to like skirmishers or archers. I don't know why, it's just a personal preference. Just advance just a tiny bit more, see if I can draw them out. It'll make the siege a lot easier. If I can bring that main army out in the open and just rip into it from outside the gates. Seeing where I'm at in here. Still working on that. That'll probably pop up right after we conquer the Aedui. And then we got that done. So that's something. Give these guys one more turn. Because they can't recruit anymore. They're at full army size. So yeah. This will definitely. Oh, that's because you did mercenaries. Oh, let's see what you did there. Even right now, they're. Even though they outnumber me unit wise, I'm in full strength, and some of my units have rank already. Let's end turn and go from there. was trying to play Total War Warhammer the other day, and my computer doesn't quite run it as smoothly as it does with Rome 2. And there's so many playable factions in that game. Playable and non-playable, but there's so many factions that the screen here where every faction's getting their turn, it takes forever. And I could literally get up, you know, cook some food, switch laundry around, do a couple of chores, come back, and it would still be going through everyone's turns. Now, they didn't want to come out. They just brought out another guy. They're just spending a shitload of money. Sending my guy down north or south yet. So alright, we'll end turn here. Oh crap, I might go to attack. Okay, I'll give it one more turn. Was unexpected. Can't recruit anyone from
as clouds gather, wise men look for friends to sell to them. In you, I believe we have such friends.
Sure. Let's do. Damn it. Close from authority. Supply. Yeah, worth that one.
Honor the gods and your ancestors!
That's what you call. Okay, so I'm gonna just straight up attack. So the ladders, yeah, that should be fine. Let's just do a quick save. And go ahead and man this assault ourselves. Yeah, I know, my graphics memory's running low, it's always running low. up attacking in winter, not what I was trying to do. Oh. Looks like right here is going to be the best bet. Alright, let's get some kind of formation. That's good. Let's do it. Be pretty freaky to see. Start taking some of these guys down. Amen. Got some wavering. Oh shit. Standing there with the cavalry. Shit, that'd be Freeman for you. Please. Oh, of course, my Celtic Eagles. Yeah, I know.
An entire unit has perished.
Sending in everybody. I definitely overestimated or underestimated my opponent here.
Our men flee the field of battle. This is a shameful display.
They're out of ammo anyway, might as well just throw them in. Oh, here we go, got some wavering on their end. Chipping away at them, at least. Alright, here comes my definitely way more better infantry units. Okay. There we go. There we go. Now they're starting to.
An entire unit has perished.
At least, yeah, at least they are getting kind of messed up here. Get behind them while you can. Good stuff. Good stuff. Break. Come on. Come on. Finish these guys off. Okay, there's a couple of them.
The enemy's in units.
I know. I know. Alright. Just get these guys while their backs are turned.
Favor.
general. Let's go ahead and capture that town center. Looks like, yeah, their army's done. Just have the general to take care of. I know you guys are tired. I know. I get it. I get it. Come on. A little faster. Come on. She is. What the hell is that about? Oh, yeah, there you go. Fucking Xena there. Oh, that's
the enemy general is dead.
She died. Yeah, I won't argue that. That was very poor strategically. Holy boy. All but one. Levy Freeman. Oh man, that's bad. These swordsmen here got the most kills. Damn, almost 100. And looks like these Levy Freeman did the most damage on their side. Imperium. There we go. All that's right is my king versus her queen. Headhunters. Let's change that. I've never been crazy about that. And I am for these guys. Let's see. Actually, let's go ahead and get us some stables so we can get some cavalry. I'll send Lugios down here. Basically do the same process of starving them out. Alright. Well, let's see if we can parlay with the king.
I am sure you have many pleasantries for me, but please don't bother. Talk of meat, not honey.
I wonder if I can just try this. Peace treaty, joint confederation. Offer basically what we have. Left. Still low.
My ancestors were quite inventive.
Fine. Alright, so now we have. We know where the nerve is.
There's a good pork roasting for you. I'm bitter ale and meat.
Good.
All praise to the gods. They have led us to wisdom. My people can only dream of wealth like yours. Can you not spare some
trade on top of it? I'll pay $200. That's fine. Oh, you petty bitches.
An end to overlong talk. Your offer is not what I want to hear. My throat yearns for ale. My ears for silence.
Yeah. You want some money?
Your people are a byword for honor, but I cannot quite accept the terms that you offer.
Why is he being such a dick? I mean, seriously, like, no, he's got no reason. Oh, damn.
Oh, God.
Fine. Fuck you. Fuck you. Alright. These are the. These are the ones they're really wanting, so let's do the Russian Pact, Treaty Agreement, plus military access on there, off out of boom, very good, very friendly, and some alliance,
your people are my word for honor.
Alright, we'll work on that later. Whenever you want to be a bunch of petty bitches. So. Alright, got him going down there. Can we still get that meal? Get the other guy off later. Oh boy. Alright. I have to at least fill in some of the empty Freeman slots. That's a couple of scriptures. Just get a couple more Freeman in there. Da-da-da-da. technology yet. Let's see. Let's do one more turn and probably call it a night after that.
Difficult to make your ship, but
yeah. So we've pushed into Celtica. This one. The second battle of Iraq. I've got some garrison army troops. Not a whole lot, it's only 24. It's barely barely a single unit. Buyers can't be choosers. Oh, jeez. Alright. Let's go ahead and put our archers. I don't want to completely destroy my garrison forces. Let's go ahead and start it. Smart move. Most of those watchtowers are going to whittle you down a little bit. Because for whatever reason, these watchtowers have like goddamn snipers in there. Every shot's a headshot, basically.
battle is turning in our favor. Our general is under attack. One of our units has used all its ammunition.
It was a good try. Don't give them, think we're assholes. See if he's willing to make peace now. Choice, they got army coming in. Oh no. Alright, well. There's nothing we can do about that. They don't seem to be coming at me. It's knowledge of the oak. It's got some benefits to it. Let's see.
God of the afterlife, spare my arse! Well, why do you trouble my digestion today?
So I just come the whole 2000.
Peace!
Yeah, fine. I mean, at least nine guys. I'm not gonna. Just gonna all resolve. Very cool spot for that to happen, actually. There's still our people. let's do verbal swordsman. Do infantry command.
I fear our ancestors' unhappiness if I accepted, generous as your offer seems.
There we go.
Yes.
There we go. Now we got the Cherusky who we cannot trade with. Let's see if we can achieve our
welcome, worthy friend. Things. Let us break bread and drink ale before words pass our lips.
Offer him. This is. Oh, there we go.
I will take word of our agreement and put it before my people.
Oh, damn it. Yeah, see, that logo is just ugly in that color scheme. Just me. Alright, well, I'm gonna call it a night. Thank you for joining me on this, episode one of this campaign. Yeah, I'm sure it was something, I'm sure it was not the most, exciting gameplay. But it's all about having fun. Alright, take care.